Welcome to Grab & Go Info. Recommendation systems have become integral to industries ranging from online retail to digital media. Two popular recommendation techniques are user-based and item-based collaborative filtering. But why limit ourselves to one when we can reap the benefits of both? This article explores how to build a robust hybrid recommendation system leveraging both of these strategies. User-based collaborative filtering review. The user-based collaborative filtering discovers the similarities between users based on their behavior history. It operates on the idea that if two users have similar behaviors in the past, they will have similar behaviors in the future. To generate recommendations for an active user, we locate other users who have a similar pattern. We then recommend items highly rated by these similar users that the active user hasn't interacted with yet. Please check out my previous tutorial on user-based collaborative filtering Python implementation. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Item-based collaborative filtering review. Item-based collaborative filtering computes the similarity between items based on user ratings. If two items have been highly rated by a similar group of users, we can infer that they are similar. To provide recommendations to an active user, we locate items the user has rated highly and identify other items similar to these items. The similar items, unseen by the user, become our recommendations. Please check out my previous tutorial on item-based collaborative filtering Python implementation. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Types of hybrid recommendation systems. Hybrid recommendation systems combine user-based and item-based collaborative filtering. They offset the weaknesses and harness the strengths of both techniques. Here are a few hybrid recommendation methods. Weighted hybrid. A weighted hybrid system assigns different weights to recommendations from both techniques based on their respective performance. Mixed hybrid. The mixed hybrid concatenates the recommendations from both methods. Switching hybrid. In this flexible approach, the system switches between user-based and item-based methods, depending on the situation. For instance, if the active user has a rich history of ratings, a user-based method might be more suitable. Feature combination hybrid. Features derived from both methods are blended and fed into a model to generate recommendations. Next, we will talk about how to implement each of the hybrid methods. Weighted hybrid recommendation systems. Let's assume we have already developed a user-based and an item-based recommendation system, and we want to build a weighted hybrid recommendation system. We can combine these methods by assigning a weight to the recommendation coming from each system. Firstly, you would run your user-based and item-based recommendation system separately to generate recommendations along with their corresponding scores. For instance, let's say we are trying to recommend movies for a user. Your user-based system suggests movie A with a score of 4.5 and movie B with a score of 4.0, while the item-based system recommends movie A with a score of 3.5 and movie C with a score of 4.7. To combine these recommendations into a single weighted recommendation list, you'd multiply the scores from each system by the respective weight and add them up. The weights can be determined based on the historical performance of each system. Say weight user-based equals 0.6 and weight item-based equals 0.4. These weights indicate that we trust the user-based recommendations slightly more than the item-based recommendations. Now, calculate the final scores for the movies. For movie A, final score equals 0.6 times 4.5 plus 0.4 times 3.5 equals 4.1. For movie B, final score equals 0.6 times 4.0 plus 0.4 times 0 equals 2.4. For movie C, final score equals 0.6 times 0 plus 0.4 times 4.7 equals 1.88. So, the final recommended movie list in decreasing order of scores would be movie A, movie B, and movie C. Remember, these weights are not static and can be adjusted over time to optimize the system based on performance metrics. Please check out my previous tutorial, The Ultimate Guide to Evaluating Your Recommendation System, for more details about recommendation system evaluation. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Mixed hybrid recommendation systems. For the mixed hybrid approach, you would run both the user-based and item-based recommendation systems and then merge their recommendations. Unlike the weighted hybrid approach, you don't assign any weights to the systems here. Suppose your user-based system recommends movie A and movie B, while the item-based system suggests movie A and movie C. A simple way to mix these recommendations is to combine them into a single list. Movie A appears in both lists, so it could potentially be given a higher priority. The final recommendation list could look like this: movie A, movie B, movie C. It's important to note that with the mixed hybrid method, there are different ways you can handle the overlap of recommendations. The order of the final list can be determined by the order of recommendation from each system. By favoring one system over another, by the score of the recommendations, or by any other rule that you think provides the best recommendations for your users. Ultimately, the goal of a hybrid system is to enhance the quality of recommendations by taking advantage of the strengths of both user-based and item-based collaborative filtering methods. Switching hybrid recommendation systems. In a switching hybrid method, the system switches between user-based and item-based collaborative filtering based on certain conditions or context. It's like having a decision rule that tells you when to use one approach over the other. Let's consider an example. Suppose you are running an e-commerce website and want to recommend products to your users. You have both user-based and item-based recommendation systems in place. Let's say user is a new user with very few ratings in the system, but they have viewed a significant number of items. For user A, an item-based approach could be more beneficial as we can recommend similar items to those they have viewed or interacted with, even though they have not rated many items. On the other hand, user B has been on your platform for a long time and has rated many products. For user B, a user-based approach might be more beneficial because we can find other users with similar tastes and recommend items they liked but user B hasn't seen yet. In this case, the switching rule can be based on the number of ratings the user has provided. If the number of ratings is below a certain threshold, use item-based recommendations, otherwise use user-based recommendations. Remember that the decision rule for switching can vary based on the application and domain. It should be chosen carefully, with the goal of maximizing the relevance and usefulness of the recommendations for the user. Feature combination hybrid recommendation systems. In the feature combination hybrid method, features derived from both user-based and item-based methods are combined and used as input to a model that generates recommendations. Consider an online movie recommendation system with both user-based and item-based models at its disposal. Here's how a feature combination hybrid method might work. 1. Feature generation. For each movie, you generate a set of features. These could include user-based features, average rating given by the user, user's rating of similar movies, number of movies rated by the user, etc. Item-based features, average rating of the movie, number of users who rated the movie, similarity of the movie to other movies the user has rated, etc. 2. Model training. You then use these features to train a machine learning model. This model might be a simple linear regression, a decision tree, a neural network, or any other type of model that can handle your feature set. The dependent variable for model training is typically the rating that a user gives to an item. The idea is to train a model that can predict this rating based on the features you've generated from the user-based and item-based methods. The predicted rating represents how much the system expects that a user will like an item. 3. Recommendation generation. To generate recommendations for a user, you'd input the user-based and item-based features for all unrated movies into your trained model. The model then predicts a rating for each movie. 4. Top-end recommendation. Finally, you'd sort these predicted ratings and recommend the top-end movies to the user. The beauty of this method is that it can efficiently handle and combine information from both user-based and item-based perspectives. It also easily incorporates other types of information, making it a very flexible approach to building a recommendation system. The takeaway: hybrid recommendation systems present a flexible, adaptable, and robust method to personalize content for users. By incorporating both user-based and item-based collaborative filtering, they provide an efficient solution to leverage the benefits of each method, while compensating for their individual weaknesses. Pros of hybrid methods: they mitigate the limitations of both collaborative filtering methods. They offer a more comprehensive, personalized user experience. They are capable of handling a wider variety of situations, especially when compared to standalone methods. Cons of hybrid methods: complexity can be higher as they involve combining multiple methods. They require careful tuning and optimization to ensure the appropriate balance between different methods. Cold start problem remains a significant challenge for new users and items. Despite these challenges, hybrid recommendation systems continue to be a popular choice for many applications due to their improved performance and versatility. As the field of data science continues to evolve, these systems will no doubt continue to advance and provide even more sophisticated and personalized recommendations. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about how to evaluate the recommendation system, please click the video on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.